Hi students, good morning one and all. Today we are going to discuss about the National Security Depository Limited and CSDL, Central Security Depository Limited. So in last class I already explained about the depository and I given small introduction about NSDL as well as CSDL. Today is a continuation of that session. So please go through this information for your better understanding. Let's begin this session. If you want more updated informations regarding common subject as well as stock exchange, please subscribe the channel and click the bell icon. If you click the bell icon, you will get the notification whenever I uploaded the new videos on these topics. Let's start the session without wasting the time. NSDL, it is one of the apex institution when it comes in the dematerialization of securities. So the full form of NSDL is National Security Depository Limited. The main work of NSDL is one of the main institution, plays a very important role in the settlements the conversion of securities in physical form to electronic form. And NSDL is the first and the largest depository in India. It is the first organ, the first institution established, and it is the largest depository in India. And NSDL is established in the year of August 1996. And in depository system, the ownership and transfer of security taken place by means of electronic book entries, means the securities are transferred seller to buyer through the electronic form, through the help of DMAT accounts. And next, at the outset, this system writes the capital market of dangerous related to handling of paperwork. Yes, it avoiding lot of risk for sellers, because the handling of physical form of security is very very riskiest one, because so many frauds may happen in place of if it is a physical form of securities, means if it is a lost, if the customer is someone taken away those securities. So on that time the seller has to face the problems, and sometimes the security may destroy, it may tear like that. So this kind of things are not at all happening whenever it comes to the electronic method. So next, promoters and shareholders of NSDL. The promoters means the supporters at the initial, and the shareholders means whatever the banks having their investment or invested their money in NSDL. First promoter, that is Industrial Development Bank of India. Now it is, we will call as IDBI, Industrial Development Bank of India. Next, Unit Trust of India. Then National Stock Exchange of India Limited, that is NSE. Other shareholders, means other than these promoters, are SBI, HDFC Bank, Axis Limited, Citibank and Standard Chartered Bank, Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation Limited, Union Bank Limited, Canara Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank Limited, Deen Bank Limited and Kotak Mahindra Life Insurance Company Limited. Means these are the major promoters and the major shareholders for National Security Depository Limited. Next, this was the basic information about NSDL, and next we will move on to the Central Depository Services Service Limited. So Central Depository Service Limited, we already discussed about the NSDL. CSDL is the second largest Indian depository. Yes, first place is NSDL. And second place is CDSL, that is Central Depository Service Limited. It is a second largest Indian depository place, and it is located in the head office located in Mumbai. CDSL was promoted by BSE, Bombay Stock Exchange. Over there, NSDL is supported and promoted by NSE, and CDSL is supported by BSE as well as and jointly other than BSE, SBI, BOI, Bank of Baroda, HDFC and Chartered Bank and Union Bank of Limited. This institution also, these banks were also supported or promoted the BSE CDSL, that is Central Depository Service Limited. And Central Depository Service Limited was set up with the objective of providing convenient, depending and secure depository services at affordable cost to market participants. Means their main objective means providing a convenient and secure depository service, means the dematerialization of security services at the lower price. For whom means? For the market participants, either depository participants or investors. Affordable with less price. This is the main objective of CDSL. And the CDSL is received the certificate of commencement of business from SEBI in February 1999. Means it got the commencement certificate from the SEBI in the February of 1990. Yes, and next, settlement of trades in the DMAT mode. Means DMAT mode means online mode, electronic mode, through the BOI Shareholding Limited. The clearing house of BSE Limited started in July 1990. Means they started the clearing house in July 1999. Thank you so much guys for your valuable time. Please go through information and give your valuable comments about this session. In next session I will explain further informations. Thank you so much guys. Have a nice day.